Namaskar students, in the last video class I have discussed about the alignment in the formatting of MS Word. In today's class I will discuss the creating list with bullets and numbers. In the practical example I will show you how to make or create a listed document with bullets or numbering. So let us see the way we can do bullets and numbering. So what is bullet? Bullet is a dot or any other symbol that are placed before the text to make a list attractive. See, this is a list with bullets, and before the common noun, proper noun and collective noun, a dot is being placed. These are called bullets. So here I will paste a text that I will give the bulleted list or numbers. Kinds of noun: common noun, proper noun and collective noun. In this I will put numbers. So how to do? First select the text and go to the border option in the paragraph outside border. Choose outside border. See a border generate over here. Now you can choose, right click and go to bullets. Any bullet you can choose from here. I have chosen this bullet. So this is one common noun. Again bullets with proper noun. Again bullets with collective noun. So kind of noun is in a column and the other parts in the bullets. Now I will show you the days in a week with numbers. So how to do? See, I have typed all 7 days in a week over here with the enter key. Now I will show you how to put the numbers. First I will select the text where I will put the numbers. First I will select, then right click over here, then go to numbering and choose any Roman numeral or any numbers. If I choose this, so see it coming 6 days. Now in 7 days when I will press enter key, then automatically the number will come, the next number as 7. So I can write Saturday. Again I entered and came that 8. So I no need to take number 8, so I will just delete. Now I will put border over here. So I just choose this heading, selecting this heading, then go to border and choosing the border. You can reduce the border size from the margin area and you can move the border also. So creating list, type the list to which you want to add numbers and select them. Click home tab and click the drop down list arrow on numbering from the paragraph group and see the list style of your choice. So this way you can do also. Another way to after selecting, you have to right click to choose the numbering. Now applying border, I show you how to apply border. First select the text, then go to home tab, and from home tab you have to select the borders. From the paragraph group, select the borders and shading option. Suppose I have typed a I have typed this line. There are four types of sentences. I just want to put it into a border. So selecting the text and go to paragraph group border and choosing that bottom border. So see, a border came throughout the line. So you can reduce the size of the line from the margin itself. From here you can choose the size of the line. Now mini toolbar. The mini toolbar contains commonly used formatting commands or home tab. It appears when you select the text in document area. It is used to make changes in your document quickly. To use mini toolbar, follow the given steps. First, we have to select the text. Then, just move the mouse over here. This is the mini toolbar. This one is the mini toolbar. It will come and it just disappears. If you move the mouse on the selected text, then the mini toolbar will appear. From here you can change the formatting, text size. You can change the font size from the mini toolbar also. So this is how we can use the mini toolbar. Next, undo and redo option. How to do the undo and redo option? In the quick access toolbar, this is the undo option. Undo font formatting. If we click on undo font formatting, then the text will minimize as the previous font size. If we do redo option, then see the text is increased with the given formatting font size. So undo is used to cancel a command given earlier. To undo, click undo from the quick access toolbar. Redo command is used to reverse the action of undo. To redo, click redo from quick access toolbar. Let's come to the next topic, spelling and grammar. Microsoft Word checks spelling and grammar automatically as you type. It displays wavy red underlines to indicate the possible spelling error and wavy green underlines to indicate the possible grammatical errors. I have written two lines from page number 53, Practical in Computer Lab portion, where it has shown in the first line there is no mistake. But in second line you will see that one wavy green line and two wavy red line. So I am reading the sentence. A noun stands for male living being is said to be the masculine gender. A noun stand for female living being is said to be feminine gender. So here in the wavy green line means it is the grammatical error. Here grammatical error is a noun stands for. A noun that we have to write here stands for. And here wavy red line for spelling mistake, female. It is not I, it is E. Female living being, B-E-I-N-G. Gender, again the spelling mistake, G-E-N-D-E-R. So all wavy red line removed. But here see, again grammatical mistake. What is the mistake? We have given more space in between stands and for. So move the cursor over there and just reduce one space. Feminine gender. F-E-M-I-N-E, feminine gender. Now see, the second line have no error, grammatical error as well as spelling error. So computer, or rather MS Word 2010, will check the spelling and grammars in your typing sentences. This is how we can correct the spelling or grammatical errors. So if you don't know the spelling, again I am just writing a wrong spelling and showing you. See, here again I have made a mistake. So when you get the spelling mistake, you will just right click over here and get the many options. Right click on the word and choose the correct option from the drop down list. Here also, right click on the word wavy red line and choose the correct spelling. This is how the MS Word automatically give you correct spelling. So to check the spelling and grammar using dialog box, follow the given steps. Step 1, click the review tab on the ribbon. So first it is telling that click on the review tab, then spell and grammar from the proofing group. From here also you will get the spell and grammar here. The spell and grammar dialog box appeared with wrong spelling and it will choose the required word from the list and click the change button again. The spelling and grammar check is complete. See, the message is giving with the message box, the spelling and grammar check is completed. So this is how we can check spelling and grammar. So the autocorrect button in the spelling and grammar dialog box automatically corrects the spelling you type without having to confirm each correction. For example, if you type the definitely with wrong spelled, then type a space or other punctuation, then autocorrect automatically replaces with the definitely with correct spelling. I will show you with the example. So I have typed a line with lots many grammatical and spelling error. Now I will go to review tab and click on spelling and grammar. See, automatically it will come. Always check here spelling mistakes. So here suggestions given for check, check, it is a right spelling. So we can double click over there. Next, detection of the error, text full stop, the. What is the error? Autocorrect. You just click on autocorrect, automatically it will correct. Now again, and next mistake, automatically. Again you just click on autocorrect, it automatically correct the spelling. Check spelling and again the grammatical mistake. So what is the grammatical mistake? Suggestions given, one space is given more. So this is how we can check the spelling and grammar through this window. Again right click and check the suggestions. Computer automatically checks. So it will checks, not check. So this is the grammatical mistake that I have made. So this has been rectified and corrected by the computer. So this is how we can check the spelling mistake and grammatical mistakes in our writing. Hope you have understand the portion discussed today. This is the end of the video class. Namah Shivaya.